Jump. Hop. Jump. Hop. Hop. Jump. Hop. Jump. Whoosh. Jump. Jump. Oh. Ah. Oh. Hop. Hop. Jump. Hop. Jump. Jump. Woohoo! Jump. Jump. Woohoo!
And so it was that the world, having been built, fell apart. And I arose from within it as a vague memory to be its constructor. By its own standards would it be formed, and from its own essence. And so was I thus taken by my possible creation to decide its past and its future. Rather than fade away, the universe shrunk before my eyes, and it all lay before me in the form of a garden, and from me flowed the essence of existence. And I looked upon the madness that stood before my eyes. And I looked beyond its thin disguise. And it lay before me all that I could know. And I wandered through the gardens that it made grow.
Welcome to you and MC Operation Peace.
Thank you. Thanks. This next game is called Dirt Wheels, and it's an iPhone racer. And set to go. You have sound? Plug that sound cable in. Oh, check to make sure it's recording.
Okay.
It'll focus better if it's lower.
Now check zoom back. Back.
We are part of the Dirt Wheels team. We are a three-member team. Myself, Venkatesh, and Sandeep. Like, we are the engineers, and like I took care of the artwork and everything. I did a little bit of music. And he's like the producer, like took care of the concept and everything.
This is
turn your sound with him. He needs to turn his phone sound up.
Thank you.
This is a final checkpoint.
What's happening?
It's the final checkpoint. The game is over.
Oh, game's over. Okay.
This is actually the checkpoint counter, so it's reached 10 and this is the final.
Excellent. Thank you.
The concept of the game is to actually rotate the tiles and diffuse the number of bombs which are shown to you by connecting the diffusers to the bombs. We have an 80 second time limit, so we lose the time limit to show the game over on the high score screen.
It's called as OHEL. It's a multiplayer game of chance. Yes, as you can see, it's a multiplayer game. The original game rules state that there can be around two to five people who can play this game. So, which is why we have huge amounts of networking, which is there in this particular game. So, we've added a very intuitive lobby screen, as you can see. And to explain this game, we have got a tutorial. Can you please click on that? Yeah. So it's not visible as such. Yeah. So see. So every. So it's like an index-based tutorial. So it's all of the game stuff is there in that. Now, this game is centered about around taking bits and tricks. So what is a bit and what is a trick? So a bit is something that you need to predict, so that I will be able to take so many tricks. So a trick is basically when you play a card, someone else plays a card. So amongst four players, the highest card at that particular round wins the trick. So that is one trick. So by looking at your cards, you should be able to decide how many tricks you are going to make. So if you can make that many tricks, then you won the game. So just skim through the tutorial. So you can see we put in the images of the particular game. There's this lobby system, as you can see. So
this was on the main screen.
So go ahead. Okay. So just go back. And there are basically all the other rules, and that you guys can check it out later. Now, to introduce all of the people who worked on it, can you go on to the credit screen, please? So, I am Rahul. There is Darpan. We have Aparna.
Hi.
Jaskaran. And Sandeep.
Hey.
And we, there is one person who is not present with us, who has a lion's share in this game. His name is Varun Sharma. He has been a Game Pipe student, now is working in somewhere. So basically, without him, the game wouldn't have been able to complete, let alone starting the game. So I would say start. Okay. So as you can see, there are like four devices over here, so that means four players. Each player will have an individual game on his own. So, Jesse, why don't you host a game? So this person basically hosts a game. So can you just, yeah, sure. So every time you host a game, you've got to give a name to the game. Just put in your name. So, yeah. So now he has hosted a game. Now all the others will now be able to connect to him onto his game. So why don't you guys connect to the game? Sorry, it's a handy fair. Okay. So
we touch to connect.
Touch to connect, because everyone can now join Jaski's game. So as you see, as a person joins the game, so these are the four players which are currently now on the game, which are connected on the game. So this game basically runs on a client server model. So there will be one host who hosts the game, and others who acts as a server, others join in as clients. So Jaski, start the game, please. So you see, over here, as you have started the game, these will be, the cards first get shuffled, and everyone is distributed the card. The cards will be distributed to everyone. So can you just scroll through the cards, please? Just one. So see, this is like an individual player's cards that is available to him. Okay, and by looking at the cards, a person can bid. That, you know, I feel that I have got like good cards or bad cards. Depending upon that, I'll be able to take that many tricks. So, guys, just pin any random number. So, see, you bid So everyone, it'll be shown to everyone that Aparna has bid that much, Jesse has bid that much. So if now see, now everyone has bid. So now,
oh no!
Anyways,
not a good time.
So it's Jaskaran's turn.
Want me to connect it?
That is, yeah. So now he. So where is Jesse? Oh yeah, Jesse. So he played the card. So that card came to everyone.
Sandeep's.
Sandeep's turn.
Play other cards. So basically, he played the diamonds. So now everyone plays diamonds.
Okay.
So see, everyone. So now, at every as everyone has played, as
who's
you can see, it is indicated whose turn it is next. So only that person is allowed to play. No other person can play. He won't be allowed to play. So see, as at the moment, the ace of diamonds is the highest card, right? So,
it's Aparna's turn. Aparna.
Yeah, Aparna play. Right. So ace is the highest card, right? So the ace wins. So Jaskaran had played an ace, so he's got one trick over here, as you can see. So now does he start? Okay. So this is how it progresses. So everyone, see, so everyone has bid their in respective bid, which are reflected over here. Can you just move out, please? Yeah. So see, Jaskaran has bid 5 cards. He's made one trick, which is over here. Everyone else has not made anything. So basically, once they start making, they'll reflect in that. So yeah. So that's how the game progresses. Now, if you make an exact number of tricks, you basically win this game. Otherwise, you lose this game. So this is basically the logic of the game. And there is one other subtle thing that is there. So suppose if you play a card and that particular suit, no one else has that suit. The other person can throw a trump card, which is basically a suit that supersedes the current suit which is being played. So that card is called as the trump, which is indicated. So initially the trump will be, it rotates in a cyclic order. So in the first game it will be clubs, then spades, diamonds, and then hearts. That's how it keeps on going. So now see, this person has started with a heart. This person has played the clubs. Now clubs is the trump. So the trump will win this round. So yeah. So that's how Sandeep won this round. So this is how this game progresses. We had a lot of difficulty in getting the network set, because this game involves a very high level of networking, and syncing 5 devices together was a very uphill task. So now, we faced a lot of network congestion issues, in which certain messages which were passed, they were broken down and hence not received properly. So we worked a lot on getting the network as robust as possible, as you can see over here. So the cards basically come to all the players. We wanted that we should replace the actual use of cards by using the iPhone. So there are places wherein, suppose let's say you're in an office, you can't play actual cards right out there. So there are places wherein you can substitute that by your phone. So that's why we made this game, and we want to release this thing on the App Store, but there are a lot of future extensions which need to be put in. One being that we want to, right now it's running on Wi-Fi. We want to put this thing on Bluetooth, so that even if you're traveling or something and you don't have a Wi-Fi network, you can still play the game. The other thing that, as you can see, is not there is a single player AI. The AI part of this would be pretty much complex, because out of scope of this semester. So we want to put in that and then release the game. And and finally, we needed a sound artist basically for this game. So to someone who could provide us with good sound So that's why we want to take the next class in the next semester, so we can finish and polish this game with good sound and good AI. So that's go ahead.
So Zuma on the center. Okay, there we go. Zoom more a little bit. More?
Cool.
Okay.
Hey, what's up?
Yeah, that's the way you order.
I just zoom out.
Right, just smell.
It was
You're a little bit out of
focus.
Out of focus.
Nada más que eso. ¿Qué hago?
मेरा नाम मतले मैंने थोड़ी निकाला
फ्लाइट पे लेके जाते
हैं उनके घर में है
मैंने थोड़ी निकाला भाई
दूसरे बंदा का डोडा का बोलते सारे उसके आइटम होते हैं
You do great 7,000. Go ahead, you can do that.
Look at the like gauge what it's dropping right now, it's possibly really high.
Anyone, Nitin's device is already iceberg.
Hi, this is Harish here from the Rooster Shooter team. I'm going to show you Rooster Shooter, an iPhone first person shooter game. Let me go ahead and click. Okay, this was made using CocoStudy and it was developed as a part of the CACFI 26 coursework at the University of Southern California. Now let me quickly run you through the main characters of the game. Let me scroll down to the Rogue Rooster. So this is the main villain and his aim is world domination, and he's planning to do this by injecting viruses onto chickens and turning them to zombies, and he's doing this by spreading it to zombie hens. So your aim is to kill as many zombie hens as possible. So this zombie hen over here is carrying the virus and spreading it to the nearby farms. So alpha males is another unit of Rogue Rooster. It's a superior unit and it does not have the virus, but it helps give the zombie hens cover. You play the role of Peter Maximus, and Peter Maximus is a technically and genetically modified fighting unit, and you play him and kill as many Rogue Roosters as possible. So now let me go to the help contents and show you. Actually, you click the panel on the different targets and click it to kill it, and there are two main gestures in the game. One is to reload the gun of Peter Maximus, and the gesture is moving left and right, and the other one is flip or flick. This is to remove the net that which are thrown by the alpha males and the Rogue Rooster. That is an attack tactic by the Rogue Rooster and alpha males. So now let me go ahead and play the game. Skip. Let me briefly pause the game to explain the various interface which you see on the screen. You see the timer here, the remaining bullets, the score, and you can also see a small icon of Rogue Rooster. He's actually sitting at a different location and seeing what's happening. And when you reach the score of 40, he comes down and takes the fight all by himself. So let me go ahead and restart the game. So you tap to kill. You just need one bullet to kill the zombie hens and the alpha males. So you can see a prompt to reload the gun because you ran out of bullets. So I've just reloaded the gun. Now let me continue with the game. So when you reach the score of 10, you will hear a different background music and the alpha males start to appear. So the alpha males and Osara to appear. Now they can start attacking us by throwing nets at us. Now it again prompts me to reload. Now I've reloaded it. See, now they've thrown a net at us, and we use the flip or flick gesture to remove the net. So now let me reach the score of 40 and now I can show you the Rogue Rooster curve. You can see the Rogue Rooster has come. He has got a shield and armor, so he takes more kills to die. Now we are running out of time, so let me see if we can kill the Rogue Rooster. We did a hit once, reloaded, and unfortunately we've run out of time and my score is 47, which is not bad. So hope you liked our game. Our game is soon going to be on the Apple App Store, so go ahead and download it and enjoy the game. See ya, bye bye.
Okay, let's try that again. This is Holy Cow. The title screen. And let's start the multiplayer. They've found each other now, and let's hope they connect. I'll accept. So this guy's gonna be the host, this guy's the guest, he wants to be the thrower, and the one below would be the skater. So as you can see now, I just zoom in on one player, the skater. He is controlled by the accelerometer. And you can see it's pretty easy to move him. Now what I do is, if I want to throw a balloon at the person standing above me, I just slash on the screen. And there she got hit, and she got hit again. And she got hit again, and she got hit again. So now, if you look at the other iPhone, here you have the same screen, and what this one does is that she has a water gun. He throws water. She's trying to hit the other guy with water. Controlling the water gun is simple too, just a horizontal slash will keep you rotated, and there's also an accelerometer function here to move the player. So now if I hit him enough, what's going to happen is that what you can see is the other player playing on the network is being synchronized, and there's a red line at the top that shows, that is something like a health meter, but just the opposite. It shows you how much you have been colored. If that line extends fully, you lose the game.
So he's hitting the girl pretty badly now. Just lost. And skater just won. So that's it. Pretty simple game. That's holy cow for you. And there you go. Those are the two screens and synchronization. Thank you.